The resignation of a senior Labor frontbencher has exposed deep fractures in the party over its climate and energy policies. Today, Joel Fitzgibbon confirmed that his departure followed a heated exchange with his leader, Anthony Albanese.
You guys would have enjoyed a bit of colour and movement.
If you want to see the future, study the past.
Saw a guy going on a pot plant once, you might recall.
Joel Fitzgibbon has form in using the media to create a sense of chaos around Labor leaders, from Julia Gillard...
Really dangerous.
..to Anthony Albanese.
My mate Albo and I have had some dust-ups.
Today he confirmed an angry exchange with his leader over climate policy before he resigned from Labor's frontbench.
Our climate and energy policies have cost us two recent elections.
He says he's not trying to force Anthony Albanese out.
He's able to bring the left back to the centre.
But it doesn't help.
Is Joel Fitzgibbon trying to destabilise your leadership?
No, he's not.
As the relationship with one leader sours, another is blossoming as the member for Hunter hands the government a weapon.
This leader of the opposition is so desperate, leading a party so divided.
The member for Hunter, aka General Custer,
he has had enough of the cheesecloth brigade.
There is no move against Anthony Albanese, and rule changes since the Rudd-Gillard era have made leadership spills harder. But Joel Fitzgibbon is stirring up disquiet about leadership in the party ranks and enraging others.
You can say what you want from the backbench, but it doesn't represent the views of the party.
But it does do damage. Chris Yulman, Nine News.